Hey Hawks, welcome back to CSN. We're covering all things Valentine's season.
From Valentine's events to couples guides, we have a jam-packed show for you this week. So stay tuned because Centennial Student News starts right now.
One of the best parts of each month is the fine flea market held downtown.
This specific market only happens once a month, so our reporter went out and got all the details. Check it out.
The fine arts flea market only happens on the first Friday of every month. This month's theme is For the Love of Artists, featuring local artists' work aimed at getting them more exposure. We spoke with a few of those artists. Here's what they had to say about the community and why they choose to sell their artwork.
I think it's a really nice community. Everybody's really friendly, and it's a chance to like meet new people of all different walks of life.
The art community is gaining more and more popularity as more opportunities to spread the love and beauty of art to people of many different backgrounds have emerged. It was made very clear that many artists enjoy spreading the love.
What I like about selling art is because I enjoy what I do. It's my passion in life. Lots of other people, lots of kids enjoy doing artwork as well. And so when they see my work, I encourage them to keep going, pick up a pencil, and just keep drawing.
One of the most desirable aspects of art is that it has no boundaries. It's up to the artist's discretion of what they choose to create, giving people the opportunity to produce whatever they've ever dreamed of making and setting their imaginations free.
What do we enjoy about making art? I think just the entire aspect of it. You could be really creative and get weird with what you make. It doesn't have to have a set standard of what it has to look like. So I think it's really fun that we could explore all that with art.
The Fine Arts Flea Market is a great way to spread the love to your local artists. Don't forget to mark your calendars for next month's market. It's a family-friendly event filled with lots of shopping, music, food, and fun. For Centennial Student News, this has been Katie Barrett-Hewis reporting.
Thanks, Katie. Next up, Johnny visited with Grounded and one of their owners.
They discussed building the small business and what they're planning for Valentine's Day. Here it is.
Hey Hawks, I'm Johnny Renteria, and I'm here at Grounded to ask them some questions about opening a small business here in Las Cruces.
Grounded was successful as soon as they opened, so I talked to co-owner Kendra Spiritu about how they built this one-of-a-kind space.
When we were really little, we had like always been traveling and trying out new coffee shops. Even before we could drink coffee, we were just like sitting there reading, like hanging out, and every time we would travel, we would go to different places and kind of like write down or keep note of like our favorite parts of it. And like one day for our favorite our personal coffee shop, like these are the little pieces we would bring to ours. And so in COVID, this space opened up, and then I was graduating from college. My dad was retiring from the fire department. And yeah, we just kind of did it, and we squished everything that we love together.
Grounded is set on being a staple in the community, supporting their team and doing what they can to add to Las Cruces.
We're always looking to like evolve and not expand necessarily, because Grounded is so special. We don't really want to like replicate it exactly because it's so unique, but growing in the sense of like providing opportunities to our employees, growth in that aspect, like people that really want to see a career in the restaurant industry, in the food service industry, providing opportunity for them to maybe do some personal development stuff in that aspect, maybe manage a cafe themselves if that's a dream of theirs. And then also just expanding in other routes too. Like now that we know that we can do this, we kind of want to bring other things to the community that we think is lacking.
If you're looking for a Valentine's Day destination, Grounded is the perfect place to stop by.
This year's really special for our Valentine's events. We have a really beautiful three-course dinner that we're offering. So it's three courses that we make in-house, and it's going to be beautiful and like kind of fine dining, fancy, candlelit. It's going to be reservation only too. So usually Grounded is kind of like a casual dining place, and so this will kind of put us on the map for like a date night or like romantic. But on Valentine's Day, actually, from 6 to close, we're gonna have that three-course dinner. So it'll be really nice and cool. We haven't done that before, so it'll be fun. That's gonna be really special, but we'll also be available just for like walking in, getting a coffee, We have also this week Valentine's like make your own mug ceramic night. So you can come in and like build your own mug and paint it. And so like kind of like a Galentine's Day or just like a little date night.
Overall, Grounded is a unique and community-oriented small business focused on providing a versatile environment for anyone who might walk through the door.
Let's take it back to Joanna and Layla. For Centennial Student News, this has been Johnny Renteria reporting.
Since it's the season of love, Bailey and Evan are giving you the couple's guide to Valentine's Day.
Check it out.
Another year being single means another year of the Single's Guide to Valentine's Day.
Single? Are you kidding me right now? Are you being for real single?
And this is the Couple's Guide to Valentine's Day.
Nice way to start off your Valentine's Day is cleaning yourself up and picking out a nice outfit for the day.
Valentine's Day is the perfect opportunity to either go big and bright or just plain casual. A little this, a little that, and you're ready to go.
Look at you. You're looking good and you're feeling good. Now you're both ready and you're out and about, head to a store, buy some snacks, enjoy the time you have together.
There's a wide variety of heart-shaped boxes on the shelves, but choose the one that reminds you most of them.
The day is only as fun as you make it, so from time to time, throw in a little bit of chaos.
Done with your shopping, take a nice stroll in the park, enjoy the nature, the sun, and contemplate with your partner on raising a duck army.
If long walks in the park isn't your thing, then there's always the local arcade, heading over there with your player too. Remember, it's your guys' night out, so enjoy it. Have a good time. Don't forget to be competitive with each other.
Once the sun goes down, it's time to end the night off with the sweet embrace of a nice meal.
Congratulations, you just made it through Valentine's Day with your significant other. Now, it's time for that check. This has been the Couple's Guide to Valentine's Day.
We'll be right back with Hawk Sports Network after this week's edition of Hawk Heat. Stay with us.
What's up, Hawks? I'm Colin Miller and this is Hawk Heat. Love is in the air and so is the weather. So from scattered showers to sunny evenings, let's take a look at this week's weather. Saturday starts us off with a high of 58 and a low of 31. Sunday has a high of 58 and a low of 28. But the weather won't be as lovely as there's a high chance of rain. This week won't be that different as Monday and Tuesday were meant to be with each other, as they both share a high of 63 and a low of 38. Wednesday's the day we've all been waiting for, as it is Valentine's Day. The high is 64 and the low is 39. If you have no one to celebrate with, just remember, the weather's by your side. Thursday will be everything you expect, with a high of 60 and a low of 40. And to end off this romantic week, we have a high of 62 and a low of 41. That's all for this forecast, Hawks. Remember to stay warm and stay safe. This has been Colin Miller, signing off.
Hi Hawks, I'm Amaris Villegas.
And I'm Jordan Trujillo. That's right, love is in the air and we're here to spread some of that Valentine's cheer with a beautiful sports update, sure to make you blush.
Absolutely. Last week on Tuesday, we played Las Cruces High School, both girls and boys basketball. We'll be taking a look at both games' highlights.
Girls basketball won 49-45. They played vigorously with many consistent baskets from Aviana Villalobos, who shot 12 points, with Elena Gonzalez followed with 8 points.
Boys basketball played at the Nest and managed to quickly wake the crowd up with Ozias Aguilar scoring the 6th point. Unfortunately, we lost 53-61, but showed great stamina and defense against the Dogs.
Our team is powerful with senior Brady Rewalt and Ozias Aguilar scoring the highest points against Las Cruces High. During halftime, we raised a total of $359 from donations from our Hawk scholars and families.
Stay with us as we dive into all things baseball and softball. Spring season sports are close to starting. Last weekend, our Centennial Hawk fast pitch and our baseball teams had their first scrimmage.
Baseball and softball are holding scrimmages in order to lock in their lineup going into this upcoming season.
Before we close off this update, we sent our reporter Caitlin Kraling to the NMSU cheer and dance competition.
Let's take it to her.
Hi Hawks, I'm Caitlin Kraling and I'm here at the annual cheer and dance competition at the Pan American Center. The energy in this arena is electric as we kick off the day with cheer. In the cheer division, they're going to be judged on their stunts, cheers, dance, and tumbling. Moving on, we're going to have our dance competition. Our dancers are ready to impress the judges with their choreography, synchronization, and overall performance. From hip-hop to contemporary, our sensations are ready to impress the crowd. Let's take it to the sensations and Hawk cheerleaders to finish up this report.
My name is Dr. Zamora. I've been a cheer mom for 7 years, and I've been a cheerleader 26 years ago, All-American for the Rio Grande Ravens. How I'm hoping to impact these kids' lives is that they just take this cheer sport and love it and just realize what opportunities and journeys that it can take them and just love themselves in the process. The reason I became a head coach is I love the sport, I love my students, and I wanted to continue and see this program grow. The favorite part of my team is just seeing the kids smile and have fun out there. Members this year, the interest was a lot better. We got a coaching staff to really support the program, really grow, and just right now we've got a great support system. Obviously, we'd love to win, bring home that blue trophy, but even if we don't, I just want them to really just enjoy the journey, enjoy everything that they're getting from the sport.
Hi, I'm Madison Gregory, and I've been cheering for 7 years.
Hi, I'm Sophia Salcido, and I've been cheering for 9 years.
Hi, I'm Demetria Gonzalez, and I've been cheering for 10 years.
Hi, I'm Lidona Zamora, and I've been cheering for 7 years.
I think we need to improve on, like, being committed. I think we wait until, like, a week before to, like, start giving it our all, and I think we just need to bring it all year until state.
I think we just need to be more positive and work harder.
I think we need to communicate with each other more and just fight for it more and have more, like, dedication to the team.
25 burpees.
He says 5 up downs or pressure makes diamonds, fire makes gold.
Fire makes gold and pressure makes diamonds.
He always says but, he's always adding something else to us. It's never perfect.
Eat or be eaten.
One more full out. That was tragic.
After a long day of high energy and effort, your Centennial Hawks cheer JV placed first and varsity followed with placing second in cheer with dance and third in game day. Alongside our sensations, placed fourth in large division overall. We're wishing our teams the best of luck going forward.
For Centennial Student News, this has been Caitlin Kraling reporting.
Not only is it the season of love, but it's also Super Bowl season.
That's why Dayton and Raymond got back in the kitchen to see who could make the best Super Bowl burger.
Hey Hawks, we're here, Super Bowl show.
Raymond and Dayton.
We're making burgers this time.
How much do you think the bacon's gonna shrink? Because that joint usually shrinks normally. I think I'm just gonna put this. Should I cut it in half? I should just cut it in half. So just cut it in half.
He eats too.
That's why our name is Big Eats. We're big and we eat.
We're big and we eat. Hold on, Cooper. I can't find a metal spatula, bro. That's $1. Bro, why is there barbecue on it?
Man. Because he's eating.
What are some motivational words you have for your friend over there?
Stop trying.
So how do you say it's going right now, Day in Yanaga?
It's going great.
Are you making
It's going great, and then pan to my bacon nuggets.
Let me tell you something. Barbecue burns quick. You're not supposed to mix it with your meat.
Bro, put a little bit of mustard in it to bind it all together. To keep the meat from not freaking burning, bro.
So okay, explain this to me, sir. Sir, is that mustard?
Mustard fried burger. Mustard fried. It gives it extra flavor.
That looks gross.
You look gross.
All right.
How do you feel, Daniel Naga?
I feel great.
It's my burger.
Stop fussing.
This is my bacon double cheeseburger with special sauce, toasted brioche bun, right?
Don't nobody care, bro.
Beautiful.
It's trash, bro.
Okay, bro, look at yours. That's barbecue with a side of burger, bro.
Barbecue. Barbecue with a side of burger. No bobs. I don't got a job. Oh my God. Burger with the side of bacon with the barbecue sauce, because that's just what tops it all off.
Hey guys, it's your producers Layla and Jadzia, and unfortunately we're judging the burgers today. So this is Raymond's burger. I don't want to do this job. The sauce is good. The sauce is good. It's dry.
Embarrassing.
I don't think it needed the bacon
at all.
No. I think the flavors are good. I just think it's dry.
Make sure you get a side of bacon with your burgers.
Good job. This is too much bacon for me.
Why is it pink?
Okay, this is Dayton's. Why is it pink?
What did I tell you about the pink burgers? It's not looking good for you.
This is where Lawson looks, guys.
It tastes like a sloppy joke. Let's just rate them.
Okay.
Raymond's, I am going to give like a 4 out of 10.
Whoa, where's my camera?
I'm going to show them what Jesse's
in. No, you go. Dayton's, I'm going to give a 3 out of 10. Okay. I'm going to give Raymond's a 5 and Dayton's a 4.
My final statement is, I think obviously I won. I think the judges were a little misled. I think it's because
you did win.
I know.
Oh.
I won, but the judges suck. All right. And the meat was frozen. If I had fresh meat, I would have won. The meat dried out so quick. Oh, fudge.
You literally won, Raymond.
You won.
I would have won by more points. I want to say, Raquel Torres, I love you. All that. Trayvon taught me this burger. He's in prison. Free him, though. All right, that's all I have to say. The dude I go against, he sucks. This is the second time he lost on the road. Come on, bro. Give me a new competition, bro. Stop playing.
I think Raymond sucks. No one cares about Raquel. No one cares about his cousin. I should have won, first of all. You were supposed to get the side of bacon with your side of bacon burger.
Last but not least, we hit up the campus to ask you all some Valentine's Day questions.
That's right. Here's a man on the street.
What's your ideal Valentine's Day date?
Ooh.
A drive out in the country and we dance in headlights.
I can agree with that, and going to dinner somewhere nice, and yeah.
Do you prefer flowers or chocolate?
Flowers.
Flowers.
What's your worst date story?
I turned purple.
Oh no, here's mine. So we were on our way to Sonic and he backed up into my mom's car. What's your ideal Valentine's Day date?
My ideal Valentine's Day, I would say receive flowers, go on a date, maybe a movie date. I think that's it.
Can we ask you some questions? What are your Valentine's Day plans?
I am chaperoning Love and Leadership at Mayfield's, and then I'm gonna go home and hang out with my dog Cowboy.
Nice. What's your worst date story?
That would definitely have to be when I went on a date with my then girlfriend, who is now my wife. I was walking across a mud puddle with her. I was trying to be all romantic, and when I picked her up, I walked across a mud puddle and I slipped. And I kind of did this thing where I braced myself, but when I braced myself, I like opened my hands and dropped her right into the mud puddle.
How long have you been single?
Oh, I don't know, like all my life, I guess.
Thank you so much for watching this edition of Man on the Street. And remember, the best way to stay safe this Valentine's Day is to stay single. Bye, guys.
That's all we have for you guys this week, Hawks. Make sure to follow us on Instagram @Centen Media.
Happy Valentine's Day, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.